Hello, anatomy friends. This is Dr. Alsup, and let's finish our discussion of the regional musculoskeletal anatomy of the thorax with the muscles. And really, our main focus will be on the intercostal muscles, particularly those that are easiest to see, which are the external and internal intercostals. But I do want to note that some muscles are going to be attached to or covering the thoracic cage. And these are really primarily involved in serving or moving other regions of the body. So we will talk a lot about axio-appendicular muscles that will extend from the thoracic cage, like you can see here with the pectoralis major, or from this portion of the axial skeleton to bones of the upper limb or the appendicular skeleton. So pec major that you can see here, pec minor, which is deep, and the serratus anterior even, are going to have their proximal attachments associated with a thoracic cage and then attaching to, say, the scapula or the humerus, so really more involved with moving those regions. So we'll get to those when we're talking about the upper limb. But it's not only the axio-appendicular muscles that you will see. There will be muscles that are attached to the thoracic cage that are also attached to the anterior lateral abdominal wall, the neck, and the back. So there are lots of different muscles associated with the thoracic cage, but it's really only these intercostal muscles that are intrinsic in the fact that they both originate and insert within or on the thoracic cage. So, it's these intercostal muscles that are going to occupy those intercostal spaces between the ribs. So here's, say, rib 2 and rib 3, and then here is your intercostal space right here. And it's really more than just one muscle. You'll actually have three different sets of muscles running in different directions. The muscle fibers will run in different directions. The most anterior superficial of these muscles will be the external intercostal muscles. Anteriorly, as you get closer to the sternal region, the muscle fibers are replaced by external intercostal membrane. So you won't really see the muscle belly as much, but this almost tendinous looking region. Now, these muscle fibers will run inferoanteriorly. So it's kind of has this attachment superiorly to the inferior border of the rib above, and then it kind of continues down to the superior border of the rib below. And these muscles are most active during inspiration or breathing in or inhalation. It is not the muscle of inspiration that will be the diaphragm, but these will be most active and assist in terms of inspiration. The intercostal muscles, which you can see here, are going to be just deep to the external intercostals, and the muscle fibers will run in right angles to the external intercostal muscles. And these are weaker in terms of their contraction power than the external intercostals, but they will play a form of a role in terms of expiration or exhalation. Now, you can see one more muscle here, and this is the deepest or the innermost of these, and this is the innermost intercostal. It's very similar in terms of the internal intercostal. I think this illustration kind of makes it seem a bit too vertical. The fibers, I think, go a little bit more this way. But this is essentially the deeper part of the internal intercostals, and really it's only separated from the internal intercostals by neurovasculature, the intercostal neurovasculature, which will run in between the innermost and the internal intercostals. Okay, so that is it in terms of the muscles we're going to cover for the thorax, and just one quick, hopefully, a softball question, but maybe not, and if not, that's okay too. But I want you to try to think through which of these intercostal muscles that we just discussed is going to be most active during inspiration. Is it external, innermost, or internal? And pause the video if you need to. Obviously, we're only talking intercostal muscles here, but really the key of this stem is most active during inspiration. And only one of these will be most notably active, and that is the external intercostal. The internal is going to be more in terms of expiration or exhalation, and the innermost is really just kind of an extension or the deeper part of the internal, so it'll have a similar role. Okay, so that should wrap up our discussion of the thorax. Please make sure to review the concepts and the structures that we have discussed, and if there's any areas that you need more clarification or you just want to kind of talk through a concept, please feel free to reach out to me with any of those questions. Thank you for your time and attention, and have a great rest of your day.